Hello my darlings, welcome back to my channel. Today's look is this burgundy smoked out eye with a crisp wing and rich burgundy lips. You guys will also be proud that this is filmed zoomed in because I know you guys were like, zoom in, I can't see. Anyways, let's get started. I'm actually loving this primer from L'Oreal. It really smooths out my skin and fills in any pores and wrinkles. To conceal and brighten up certain areas of the face, I'm using a concealer about 2 to 3 shades lighter than my skin tone. I like the really bright look, so if you're not into that, keep it at your skin tone or one shade lighter. To contour, I use this probably every video and that's because I love it. I just put some on the back of my hand and dab it in the contours of my face, around the forehead and under my chin. To make everything melt into one and to create a flawless finish, I'm taking a foundation and just dabbing it in with a beauty blender. Make sure you don't swipe because obviously we place the light and dark shades in certain areas and we want them to stay there. I'm setting everything in place with a translucent powder, also making sure you dab this on your face. I also used a pressed powder to set the highlighted and contoured areas of my face. So just taking a light yellow shade, I'm applying that to the areas I want to brighten up. For my contour today, I kind of want to keep it a little more on the natural side if that's possible, as the eyes and lips are going to be the main focus. I'm just lightly and loosely dusting under my cheekbones, around my forehead and under my chin. I say loosely because I don't want any distinct lines, I just want it to melt into one. So I've popped my brows on. I thought I would create a specific brow tutorial for you guys because it gets quite boring watching me do the same thing over and over, so keep an eye out for that. This palette is to die for. The colours are so on trend at the moment and the shadows are super duper pigmented. I've also already primed my eyes with MAC Soft Ochre and then I'm just setting that with the leftover powder on my brush. That will just make all the other shadows blend out better. I'm just creating a halo in the crease with the colour Creation. Then taking this beautiful rich red colour called Muse, I'm placing it right in the socket of the eye. I'm also winging it out towards the outer corner so that when we put on our wing, it doesn't look like it just stops at the end of the eye. To deepen up the corners, I'm taking Icon and just focusing that on the outer V of the eye. Once I place it on there, I just want to blend out the edges and help it fade better into that red colour. The colour Aura is going to be our lid colour and this is just going to make everything else pop. Because we have been using all mattes, this is a great way to add a bit of shimmer. If that's the look we're going for, and it is the look we're going for. I'm just patting it on from the inner corner to where the other colours meet. Then just taking that same blending brush and softening out those edges. This is my favourite product ever because my name is kinda on it and also it's the blackest gel liner I've ever used. With an angled brush, I'm just drawing a line where I want the bottom of the wing to be. Then I just drag it into the eye. Keep on building up that wing until you have the thickness and length that you want. I then line the rest of my lash line and flip the brush over so the point of the angle can get right into the inner corner. I'm just touching up the outer V with Icon to balance out the blackness of the wing. With Creation, I'm smoking that out on the lower lash line, not all the way into the inner corner, but just where the lashes start. Then with Icon and an angled brush, I'm keeping the color really close to the lash line. I love this effect because it makes it look really clean and crisp. I decided to go with a light eyeliner to make the eyes really pop. Just apply a quick coat of mascara to your top and bottom lashes. Then we're popping on my favorite false lashes at the moment, the Carly Lash from Velour. I use tweezers because I find it way easier to apply. And then I just pop them on in the middle and then push down the outer corners and the inner corners. I'm highlighting the inner corner of the eye with the same product I'm going to highlight my cheekbones with. It really makes it more natural, especially with the shimmer on the lid that we have. Then just applying it to the tip of my nose. I want the blush to be quite subtle, so I'm applying it and then blending it out with a large powder brush that has no product on it. I'm lining my lips with an earthy brown. With lip paints, you don't have to use a liner, but it does make it a little more crisp and the color does last longer because I line the whole of my lips, not just the outline. I'm not doing this any special way, just literally tracing the lines of my lips. Then to apply the lip paint, I always start in the middle because when you first take the applicator out, it has the most product on it. So from the middle, you can spread that to the outer corners, but go with caution so you get that ultimate precision. What do you guys think? I'm in love with this look. If you did too, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you get to see more videos like this one. Thanks for watching.